Hello, in this video we look at equivalence partitioning and boundary value analysis. Equivalence partitioning and boundary value analysis are basic test design techniques, so you should know about them if you are a developer or a tester. Well, what is the benefit of using equivalence partitioning and boundary value analysis? First of all, it saves time in testing and it also allows you to find more defects than if you were just using some random input values in your testing. We will look at equivalence partitioning and boundary value analysis with a number of examples so you really understand these test design techniques and also remember them. So first let us look at equivalence partitioning. It is a test design technique that you can use in white box testing as in unit testing and also in black box testing as in system testing. So equivalence partitioning involves dividing the entire possible input range into partitions. So the idea behind equivalence partitioning is to test each partition once. So the assumption is that if you pick up a value from a partition, if it is an invalid partition, any value if you pick up from that partition, the system should reject that value. If you pick up any value from a valid partition, the system should accept that value. So now let us look at an example. So let us say there is a date field and you have to enter values between 1 and 31. So here we can see there are three partitions. So the first is the invalid partition. So 0 and all negative integers, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on, form the invalid partition. Then we have the valid partition. The valid partition has the values from 1 ranging through 31. And then we have the invalid partition, which is 32, 33, 34 and so on. So what equivalence partitioning means is that we should pick up exactly one value from each partition. So you can pick up any value from the invalid partition, so the first invalid partition. So let us say you pick minus 1. So the system should reject that value. Minus 1 is not an acceptable date within the month. Then you can pick up any value from the valid partition from 1 through 31. So let us say you pick 3 or you pick 10 and the system should accept that value. Then you can pick up any one value from the invalid partition, and so let us say you pick 34 and the system should reject that value. So let us look at another example of equivalence partitioning. So let us say your system accepts a username between 6 to 10 characters long. So here again we have three partitions. So the first partition is the invalid partition. So any number of characters from 0 characters to 5 characters is the invalid partition. Then we have the valid partition, which the system accepts 6 characters to 10 characters long username. And then we have invalid partition, which is 11 characters, 12 characters or a longer username. So again, equivalence partitioning test design technique involves just picking up one value from each partition and testing it out. So you can pick up any value from this invalid partition and the system should reject it. You can pick up any value from the valid partition and the system should accept it. And then you can pick up any value from the last invalid partition and the system should reject it. It should not accept any username that is more than 10 characters. As another example of equivalence partitioning, let us say the system accepts any age between 80 to 80 years except 60 to 65 years. So here first of all we have to form the partitions. So the first partition is an invalid partition from negative year value to 17 years. Then there is a valid partition from 18 to 59, because 60 to 65 years is an invalid partition, the system is going to reject these values. And then there is a valid partition from 66 years to 80 years, and then there is an invalid partition 81 years onwards. So again, equivalence partitioning involves picking up one value from each partition and testing it out. So as I mentioned before, the benefit is that instead of just picking up the values at random, so equivalence partitioning allows you to find more defects because you're testing out each and every partition. And also it saves time because you're just going to pick up one value from each partition, whether the system accepts it or rejects it, depending on whether it is a valid or invalid partition. Now let us look at the boundary value analysis test design technique. So boundary value analysis is related to equivalence partitioning because it is related to the valid partition in your input test data range. So what boundary value analysis test design technique involves is that tests both sides of each boundary. So your valid partition is going to have two boundaries, the lower boundary and the upper boundary. So you test on both sides of the boundary. So here the assumption is that the system behaves differently on either side of the boundary. So let us see this with the help of an example. Let us go back to our date example that we saw for equivalence partitioning. So here we can see that the valid partition is any date between 1 and 31. So there is a lower boundary. The boundary is between 0 and 1, and the value 0 is the boundary value just below the boundary, and the value 1 is the boundary value just above the boundary. So in boundary value analysis, what you will do is you will test for 0, and because this is below the boundary of the valid partition, the system should reject this value. Then you test with the boundary value just above the boundary that is lying within your valid partition, and here the system should accept the value. Then there is the upper boundary of the valid partition. So 31 is just below the upper boundary, so 31 should be accepted by the system, and the value 32 is just above the boundary of the valid partition, and the system should reject this value. Now let us look at another example of the BVA. Again, we saw the username which was accepted by the system between 6 to 10 characters. So here we can see that again there are two boundaries. So the lower boundary is this one. So 5 characters long username is just below the boundary, so the system should reject this value. 6 characters lies just above the boundary, and the system should accept this username. Then there is the upper boundary, and the upper boundary has a couple of boundary values. So the first boundary value is just below the upper boundary, so 10 characters, so the system should accept a 10 character long username. And there is boundary value just above the boundary, so 11 character username should be rejected by the system. So again, in BVA, what we do is we test on either side of the boundaries of the valid partition, of each valid partition. Another example of BVA is if you're using floating point values. So let us say the system accepts any value between 0.2 to 0.8. So here the boundary is between 0.2 to 0.8. So the lower boundary is just below 0.2. So here the boundary value below the boundary is 0.1. 0.1 should be rejected by the system. The boundary value just above the boundary is 0.2. 0.2 should be accepted by the system. So when testing, you have to use both 0.1 and 0.2. Then look at the upper boundary of the valid partition. 0.8 is just within the boundary, so 0.8 should be tested, and the system will accept 0.8. 0.9 is just outside the boundary, and the system should reject it. So this is what there is to equivalence partitioning and boundary value analysis test design techniques. So instead of just picking up values at random, you can use these test design techniques to give you more value in testing, save your time, and also find more defects, because a lot of defects can be found by using these techniques, because in equivalence partitioning, the valid partition and the invalid partitions are treated differently by the system. And same thing happens in the boundary value analysis. The values just below and above the boundary are treated differently by the system. So using equivalence partitioning and boundary value analysis, you can save time in testing and also find more defects. So that is all for this video, and see you in the next video. Thank you.